I'm very excited to be here today to share with you some of our work relating to application of nanopore sequencing for real-time microbial assembly. So let's start with a quick introduction about MinION device. MinION device has been used in our group for quite a long time, since 2014, at very early stage. Due to the ability to generate long reads in very rapid manners, almost real time. And we have developed a number of streaming pipeline to take advantage of the real-time property of the MinION device to answer the question quick and in a very quick manner. My project is to try to develop a streaming hybrid assembly using nanopore data, because as you know, the Illumina data is the most abundant genomics data out there. But doing assembly using only short reads would suffer from fragmented context. And so normally it's quite difficult to get the structural information out of the Illumina assembly. So number of long reads can resolve it by doing the hybrid assembly. And then we have a complete genome, so you have the structural information, for example. And what is more exciting is that MinION output can be streamed down to the downstream analysis. So we want to develop a streaming algorithm to retain this this advantage of nanopore sequencing, so that it can reduce the turnaround time and also enable the interactive controlling. So at early stage for the really for real-time scaffolding microbial genomes, we developed NP-SCAP. So the idea is quite simple. You just take a stream of long reads coming in aligned with a short read assembly using WMM or now Minimap2, and so that it can we can have the alignment record, so you know which pair of the contigs are connected to each other, and then you can put into a scaffold structure, and then when you have more long reads, you have more alignments, and the scaffold is expected to be extending. So here's the result using our pipeline, the NP-SCAP pipeline on two data sets, Klebsiella and the yeast, the Saccharomyces. So when the MinION device is running, it output more data, so you have more coverage on the x-axis. And then the N50 increase, the number of contigs decrease. You can see the arrow which represent the value of the reference. So in the case of Klebsiella, you can see that we have a perfect complete assembly. With the Saccharomyces, it wasn't, but it's very close to the value of the reference. And when compared to the available method at that time, NP-SCAP performed quite well while consuming less computational resource. And then when the barcoding kit become available, we develop NP barcode to demultiplex the nanopore reads, so you can break the stream into substream corresponding to different barcodes. And then the substream can be piped to NP-SCAP so that the individual genome can be completed at the same time when you're running the barcoding experiment. So that's a story about real-time scaffolding for the isolated bacterial genomes. So the next step is that we want to do it on the assembly graph, because normally the short read assembler output the assembly graph with richer information than just the context. And you may be aware of this tools, Unicycler, developed by Ryan Wick just 7 months after NP-SCAP. It's a really cool tool that can use the long reads and then run the consensus on all the long reads spanning one bridge, and then use that consensus read for the pathfinding, And then when you have when you can identify the path, you can bridge the graph, and then by doing so, you can do the assembly. So we want to have a real-time assembly working on the assembly graph. So we develop NP graph. It's the hybrid assembly working by resolving the assembly graph by using the non-nanopore long reads. And we want it to work still in real time, like doing the streaming input and output. So the pipeline can be divided into two main phases. First is the offline phase, when you do the graph pre-processing, in which you load the debris graph output by a short-read assembler like Spades or Velvet. And then you do some polishing, you remove the noise and calibrate some of the metadata, like the coverage information, so that you can better estimate the multiplicity of the components by running some binning algorithm. And then there come the online phase, when you resolve the graph in real time together with the mainline running. So this step can be done by using the long reach to bridge the unique nodes, or we call the anchor context. And you can do the cleaning and simplifying the graph at the same time, so that you can see the graph is like simplified together when the nanopore is running. Here is for the binding algorithm in the pre-processing step. I just stole the idea from MetaVelvet when they try to fit a language-weighted frequency of the context into a mixture model of Poisson distribution, and then try to identify the peaks and then assign the bins appropriately. But this not work in normally, like sometimes it's not work because the peak is very close together and very difficult to identify. So there's another option, is that you provide the file, the binding file that provide the assignment of the context to a bin by, for example, running MetaBat2 or MaxBin, or even doing some manual curation. And then you can use that binding file as a augmented input to NP graph, sorry. And after the pre-processing step, we do the bridging. So there's two cases. The first one is that the two anchors node like not connected together in the Debussin graph, because when you choose different k-modes or there's underrepresented Illumina data, then we have to use the long reads consensor to fill in the gap. And the second case, if you have a good quality Debussin graph, then if there's two anchor contexts that suggests to connect together by the long read, then there's very likely that is also belong to the same connected components in the assembly graph. And if that's the case, then you can just use the long reads to find the path. And then when you have the path in the assembly graph, you can fill in the gaps with this high quality data. So this is a very basic idea about graph resolving running in real time. So it's all running is like in like streaming mode. When you have more long reads, it's gonna start another processing. So to your left hand side is how you do the bridge merging. It's like when you have more long reads, the long reads suggesting the bridges, right? And you need to run, in this case, I run a dynamic programming like Nidegund or Smith-Waterman alignment to find the optimal matches and then merge the bridges together. And then when you have enough supporting long reads for the anchors and the stepping nodes in between, you can run the pathfinding to find the path between the adjacent contexts or nodes in the assembly graph. And then when a unique path is identified, as you can see from the right, highlight in purple, then you can connect it. You can connect the two anchors by one composite edge that containing the information from the step in between. And then by doing so, the knot the blue dot knot, there can be somehow untangled, and then you simplify the graph. Okay, so that's all about the theory. This is a NP graph when you are using the graphical user interface mode. So you have the control panel for the input and some statistic. And then maybe something more interesting is the graph view to the right, when you can see the graph being simplified in real time when the NAPOR sequencing output more data. So that the graph is simplified by the method I talked earlier. And then hopefully we can have some complete assembly. So this is the example run for 4 data set. As all microbiome genomes, it's less than 10 megs, but the assembly graph complexity may be ranging from several hundred nodes to you can see 10 of thousands of components over there. Here, the colored node represent the bins, and then the white one is the unbin, because we don't have enough confidence to assign to any bin. To the lower left, you can see the one plasmid has a different color than the chromosome. What we expect to see is the circular context, the big one is represent chromosome and the small one is represent plasmid, as you can see there. So here's a comparison, when I run NP graph a unicycler. So I run on 3 real data set, and then it's output a list of contigs. And the bold one is circular contigs, so suggesting the completed one. And you can see the identical plasmid detected. And sometimes the NP graph work better, but sometimes unicycler work better, so it's comparable. And then on the right side is how it perform in real time compared to NP-SCAF. So NP-SCAF, as you can see, is more greedy. So the N50 rise pretty quick, but you can see the fluctuation a little bit there in the blue line, suggesting that there's a conflict breaching afterward when there's more data coming in, and you have to break the old one and replace the better one. But for NP graph, the monotonic pattern is stable, and then it's increased until have the complete genome. We also run some quick and dirty tests on some metabolomics mock communities, Zymo for Zymo Even and Zymo Lock. In Zymo Even, when you have a kind of the same abundance for 10 of the bacteria, 10 of the microbials genomes, and Zymolog when you have very different, trying to emulate the rare species in real communities. And we compare the NGA50 of the metaspace assembly and the NP graph using metaspace assembly graph using NAPOR long reads on 8 of the PacBio references available with the same data set. And then you can see the improvement when using NP graph over there. The improvement is significant in terms when you work with Zymo Even, but with Zymo Lock, there's still improvement, but it's lesser. It's because the Illumina data is failed to capture the very low abundance CBCs. So this is graph view running the Zymo Even and Zymo Lock. So you can see the assembly graph from Zymo Lock is is very fragmented, and it's not completed. Only 1/3 of the genome is covered by Illumina data. And you can see a lot of pooling suggesting that you need to use a long read to fill in the gap instead of like traveling in the assembly graph and filling the gap by the Illumina data. So for that, there's maybe some limits when applying NP graph for metagenomics because we need a really good assembly graph. And also the preprocessing is important when you have we should run a very thorough algorithm for binning and multiplicity estimation. And also hybrid assembly like NP graph designed like to minimize the required non-poor data. So non-poor data is used for bridging only. And like if you have more non-poor data, then it couldn't have to improve the assembly coverage. And any other issue, please report to my GitHub repository. So in conclusion, we developed real-time assembly to complete genome interactively and to minimize the amount of nanopore sequencing data required. So that if you have the complete genome, complete assembly, you can stop the sequencing and also reduce the turnaround time if you use the assembly for downstream analysis. But if you have poor quality pre-assembly graph, like a string graph or a debugging graph from a short read assembly, or you don't need to worry about the saving nanopore flow cell. You got heaps of like Promethean flow cell and you want to waste them, then this is not for you. Real-time nanopore only assembly is very challenging, but something that we really want to do. For that, I want to thank the whole group, Professor Coy and Dr. Cao, my two supervisors, and the whole team. And of course, nanopore technology providing the device so my thesis is possible. Thank you for attention.